We love a takeaway baby, don't we?
Oh yeah.
But takeaway prices has gone through the roof. Yeah?
Oh it has.
So we do our own. We found a little paste, because we like a Chinese curry, yeah? We found a little paste called Mayflour Chinese curry. And how much is this a packet, baby?
About £1.20.
£1.20, and you get 250 grams worth of paste in there.
Powder.
It makes the most tremendous Chinese takeaway curry.
Chinese, you mean, it's not Chinese.
Let's see how you do it, baby. Right, okay, so what do we do to make this curry, baby?
I'm going to show you.
Well, first of all, should we go through the ingredients?
Right, okay. We have 150 grams of mushrooms, one onion, 200 grams of peas, 170 grams of curry sauce mix, 680 ml of cold water, 1.5 kilograms of chicken, 2 cups of rice, and 2 cups of water.
So we've got all that here. She's actually pre-cooked the chicken. It's not coloured or nothing. It's just literally just cooked through. It doesn't have to be coloured.
It doesn't have to be chicken.
It doesn't even have to be chicken. No, you're right, baby.
She can have beef. Leftover soap.
We normally do it with prawns, but prawns are so bleeding dear now, we get chicken a lot cheaper. So that's the reason there. Let's get these ingredients over here, baby. Let's show them how that curry sauce powder comes. Just have a look at this, folks. So how it comes in one of these little plastic tubs, and that normally comes with 250 grams in there. But we're not using 250 grams in this recipe, darling, are we?
No, we're greedy.
Why?
Because we've got 170 grams.
Well, 170 grams is less than 250.
Usually for, they suggest 85 grams.
And have we also mentioned that I only cost a pound?
Just over a pound, yeah, just over a pound
normally. Right, so how do we prepare this now?
Such a simple.
So literally, just put your paste into a saucepan.
Cold water.
And how much water we got there?
680 mils.
So just whack the water in the saucepan, folks.
Put the heat on. Skin all the time.
Yeah, and that will thicken up lovely, won't it?
Yeah, doesn't take long. And then you just add your bits in.
Yeah. Bearing in mind the chicken is pre-cooked. They're not cooked. You just chuck the mushrooms up coarsely. And also the onions we've kept in pretty big chunks as well.
Like you'd get at the Chinese.
It's exactly as you would get it as a Chinese, Sharon. So to save a bit of time, folks, what we're going to do, we're going to get the second little gas stove out we've got. Get our saucepan on for our rice, water, and all we've got here is, how much is rice?
2 cups.
2 cups of rice,
two cups.
Two of each?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so I'm gonna put that in there. There's different ways to cook rice. You might even have a rice cooker, some folks have got them, haven't they? So two and two.
Well, some people let the water boil before they tip the rice in.
Do they?
Yeah, you can do.
All different ways. You cook it how you want, folks. You cook it how you want. So we're just going to let these come to the boil. That will start to thicken up. And then all we're going to do is add the other ingredients. It's that simple. Right, it's been about 3 minutes now, folks. That's just starting to thicken up now, as you can see. So the first thing she's going to add is going to be the onions, because they're raw, they're uncooked. So they're just going to go in. And literally, just let them cook away in the heat of the actual sauce itself. And already, that rice is starting to bubble, look, in no time at all, folks. So we'll just put the lid on it. It does make a difference if you keep the lids on, folks. They cook quicker. There we go, folks. Just starting to bubble away now. Go on, baby. So just want to keep that moving.
Otherwise, do, because it will stick.
Otherwise, it will stick to the bottom. So do keep it moving, folks.
Going to add the mushrooms.
She's going in with the mushrooms, folks.
Soon bulking out this.
And can you see how quickly? I didn't think that looked a lot of chicken there, but she said, don't worry about it.
He said that's enough to feed him.
And it does bulk up quite a lot, folks. So the rice is now bubbling away. Just going to turn it down a bit and just give it a little bit of a whisk, folks. Don't want to go too mad with it. And as you can see now, everything's coming together so quickly. But this sauce, this Mayflour curry sauce.
Start adding in the chicken.
It is absolutely delightful.
It is.
Just like Chinese curry sauce. Yeah, even if you have it like the curry sauce at the chip shop, it tastes just like that.
Doesn't take long to make.
Dip your chips in. So I'm just giving this a little bit of a stir up, folks, because I don't want this to start sticking at the bottom. I'm not a rice person, to be honest with you. How are you getting on, baby?
I'm getting there.
I think that needs some more water in it, shall I? I'm actually having to put some more water in that, folks. With rice, you got, you either know how to cook it or you don't, and I don't. Hey, Sharon?
That's
right. So we'll just let that cook away on a low heat now. And as you can see, folks, we've now got a whole pan full. This has got to feed three people. Me, Sharon and Charlotte tonight.
And now we'll just add the peas in.
Whack your peas in. And I love these one pot recipes, baby. I love them.
I don't know, he's got the cheats out, he don't cook them.
Who don't? Yeah, you know that ain't true, baby. Now that's got to go three ways, so I'm really happy with the way that's turned out, Sharon.
See?
So we'll let that just cook down a little bit. Still keep stirring it because, as I say, we don't want it to catch on the
stick.
Bottom.
And also with this as well, do you sell some chips?
Chips and rice, folks. It's the future. Right, okay, folks, so our rice is now cooked and we had to put quite a bit more water in there, Sharon, didn't we?
Yes, you did.
So we're just going to put that in a colander. Now, if you've got a proper rice machine, it comes out so white and fluffy, baby, doesn't it? Because we stirred it, we released quite a lot of the starch in it, you see, so we have to wash it first, get the starch off of it. And she just gets the old kettle water there and just literally runs it through, gives it a bit of an agitation, and that releases all the starch. And there you go. There is an art to rice, baby, isn't there?
Yeah, and I've not got it.
Nor have I. We're no experts. Right, there you go, folks. That's it all heated up now. Now, we've gone one step further, as I said to you. We've got chips and rice. It is the future, Shout. It's the only way to go.
Yep.
Right, let's dish it up, baby. Let's have a look. Oh, look at that. Get it on there, girl. Mine's the plate, folks, at the end. I've got a big plate. So we're just distributing this out. There's only three of us. Look at that. Look. Oh, yes. That's the one I'm interested in at the end here. Look, it's got my name written all over it, Sharon. What would this cost if you went to a Chinese restaurant, baby?
Hang on, I can tell you.
Go on.
Shall we have a look? Chicken curry.
Chicken curry, chips and rice, baby.
Chicken curry, £5.50.
Yeah, but that's for three people, don't forget. So that's 15 quid.
So we've got definitely got more than that here.
That's £16.50. The rice?
Rice.
Boiled rice.
Plain boiled rice, £2.50.
That's about 17, 18 pounds and two portions of chips.
£2.20 a portion of chips?
There you go. You're looking at 20 plus, 22 quid, something like that, folks. And this has cost us virtually, well, not a lot at all, has it?
No, no.
And we got bigger portions, I would imagine.
Well, we got rice left over for sure. I went too mad with the rice.
Go on, baby, whack that sauce on there. You know I like all that.
Yeah, if you do too much. I mean, I done once with the prawn curry, done too much. Put it in a container and it's in the freezer.
Right, let's have a closer look at this, folks. Here we go, folks, it's takeaway night. Come on, baby, you have a go first. Just tell me what you think of that. I know what you think of it because you've been nicking it halfway through.
It is Chinese curry.
It's a proper one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, let's have a go, shall we? I'm going in, folks. You know, didn't you? You know, folks, that's good, isn't it? Oh, Sharon. It's not my fault. Oh, what do you reckon, baby?
Well, I love it, you know I do.
It is absolutely as you would expect from a high quality Chinese restaurant, folks.
So when we have Chinese takeaways now, which is very, very rare, I never have a curry. I do it myself,
it's true.
It's just good.
Thanks very much, folks. I hope you've enjoyed this one. Do give it a go and see what you think of it. It's called Mayflour.
Yeah, Mayflour.
Mayflour Chinese curry. They do a mild one.
Medium. And an extra hot. I have got the packet, which I can show you.
Yeah, get it out, baby. We've always got them in stock. And they're just over £1 a box.
That's the extra hot one.
Look at that, look. Just get them, folks. You will be convinced.
Can't get the jars, Chinese curry. No. Get these. If you like Chinese curry.
Yeah, we're not sponsored by them. We just love them. Anyway, thanks very much, folks. If you want to like our channel, hit the thumbs up And also, we'd love it if you subscribe, Cheryl, wouldn't we?
Yeah, and share, tell other people about us and get them to subscribe.
Or put our videos on Facebook, it doesn't matter. Or any other Instagram, I think you have one, isn't it?
I don't know.
Anyway, thanks very much, folks. Thanks very much, folks. We'll see you in the next video. We're off to eat this in front of the telly. See you later, folks, and bye
for now. Watching one of our videos.